Good morning, my brothers and sisters. Welcome to Abide in the World Online Bible Study Saturday. If you are the first time to join our church service online, please leave your contact information. We want to know you. If you are not the first time to join our church service, we welcome you back. May God bless you. Peace with us all. 我们的弟兄姐妹们，欢迎参加我们真道教会周六的线上敬拜。如果您是第一次参加我们的敬拜，希望您把您的联系方式留在对话框里面。我们希望认识您。如果您不是第一次参加我们的敬拜，愿上帝赐福给你，平安与我们同在。We know that all scripture is breathed out by God and profitable for teaching, for reproof, for correction, and for training in righteousness, that the man of God may be complete, equipped for every good work. God is faithful.By whom you were called into the fellowship of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. 我们知道圣经都是圣灵所默示，合于教导、督责、使人归正，并且用正义训练人，教属上帝的人得以完全，为行各样的善事而装备。上帝是信实的，他呼召你们好与他儿子，我们的主耶稣基督共享团契。So not less us to listen, give thanks this song again, and let's give our thanks for heart to our Lord first before going to the study. 那首先让我们来一起倾听一下献上感恩之心这首歌曲啊，像往常一样，将我们的感恩之心献给上帝，然后呢，我们再学习他的话语。
Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy.Because he's given Jesus Christ, his Son. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because he's given Jesus Christ.
Now let us turn on the mic and follow me to read today's scripture catechism together. 那接下来呢，请大家把麦克风打开，跟着我一起来读今天的新程教理问答，圣经教理问答。What does the third commandment teach us?
What does the third commandment teach us?
To.Give all to the Lord the glory.
Give all to the Lord the glory.
Due all to his name.
Due all to his name.
What is the fourth commandment?
The fourth commandment.
Remember.The Sabbath day. To keep it holy. Six days. You shall labor. And do all your work. But. The seventh day.
The seventh day.
The seventh
is the Sabbath.
It's a Sabbath
of the Lord your God.
Of your
God.
For? In six days.
The Lord
made the heavens.
Make the heavens.
And the earth.
And the earth.
Therefore.
The Lord
blessed the Sabbath day, and make it holy. What does the fourth commandment
teach us.
You shall
keep my
Sabbath. 好，谢谢。今天的圣经教育问答教导我们第三条诫命，跟我们说呢，就上帝的荣耀都是一切荣耀归于上帝的。那么第四条诫命呢，就让我们要守安息日。那第四条诫命教导我们呢，要守安息日。就上帝创造宇宙万物六天，第七天呢，他就休息了。我们一周呢，也是工作了这个五天或六天，但第七天星期天的时候呢，我们也要休息了。所以说，通常呢，作为基督徒，我们通常会在星期天的时候作为主日参加教会学习圣经，把这一天呢，完全交托给上帝。那很多犹太人呢，就把这个星期六作为他的 Sabbath day 啊，他们星期六不办公啊，也不接电话，也不会做任何事情，只是在家休息就可以了。所以说，在今天的圣经教育问答就告诉我们，上帝创造宇宙万物，根据他的顺序所创造的。那第七天他休息了，他也希望我们能够守他的安息日，在星期天的时候把这个周日啊，把它作为一个圣日，然后呢，把一切交托给上帝。我们现在星期六呢是英文，其实是中国的星期天，星期六晚上了，要到星期天去了。那我们星期天早上呢是主日，那希望我们能够坚持下来，然后呢将我们这样一个日子奉献给上帝，也希望上帝能够看到我们的敬畏之心，从而呢让我们能够去在他的话语里面行出他让我们所行的事情来。那接下来的时间呢，一到两分钟呢，让我们还是为过去一周和过去一年啊，马上今天是12月31号了，我们所做的错事来做一个忏悔祷告。还有呢让我们的上帝能够将他的恩典给我们啊，在原谅我们的过犯，希望呢他能够用圣灵带领我们在2023年来临之际啊，特别在今天晚上，他能够去除去我们的过犯，然后呢更新我们，让我们在新的一年里面更多的活在他的话语里面。So the following 1 or 2 minutes, let give us prayers or confession in silence. And let our Lord God to forgive us whatever we have done in the past week. And even for the past years, the whole year 2022, because today is the last day of 2022, we're heading to 2023. So let God to forgive us our transgression in the past year, and let His grace dwell in us. Let us live in His Spirit so we can all turn to the new person and change our self-behavior daily in 2023. 接下来让我们低下头在心中默默地为上帝向上帝祷告。So let us bow our head and pray to our Lord from our heart.Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Today is the last day of 2022, and we have the thankful heart, what you have given to us, what you have given to us in the past year, what you are going to give us in the coming year as well. And thank you to choose us as your children and give us life. Let us to have opportunity to live as a living sacrifice. Let us to become the winners of your glory so people can see us.To you And through Jesus Christ, we can all be saved. And especially for today's message, let us to understand what Jesus is and why he came to this world, how we should believe in him, and why we should believe in him. And for whatever we listen to your word today, please give all the blessing for whoever come online to worship you, to listen to your word. Because all the prayer, if we pray in your will, you're going to hear. If we ask, you're going to give. And please be with us. Let your Holy Spirit hold over our heart. Open our eyes to listen to your word. And I pray with your son, Jesus' name. Amen. 好，我们在圣诞节的时候呢，让大家一起来共同做了一个录音，也就是根据我们的文案来去读了一个关于圣诞节故事的，根据圣经原文我们做了一个短片。那很多人呢没有能够在微信朋友圈里看到啊，很不幸的是，朋友圈把这一个视频给屏蔽了啊。那里面可能有谈到关于圣经耶稣与这个圣诞节的问题啊，但是呢没有关系，我们在 YouTube 频道上有放出来啊，那个季姐妹应该有发给过你们，有些有条件的可以再看。那么没有条件没有看到这个视频的呢，我今天在这里也放一下啊，给大家一起看一看，在上一周的周六的时候，我们大家一起来参与的这样一个短片，你们当时读的一个音频，我们配成了视频，跟大家一起分享一下。Christmas is not a gift from this world. It's not about the decoration at will, but a gift from heaven to show us how God loves us.
After everyone left, Mary and Joseph flee to Egypt to escape the wrath of King Herod.
I had a dream from an angel of the Lord. We need to take the child and flee to Egypt together until he tells us for Herod is about the child. For the child to destroy him.
You are the head of our house. Let's do as your arrangement. We got to leave now.
And remained there until the death of Herod. This was to fulfill what the Lord had spoken by the prophet. Out of Egypt I called my son.
Let's kill all the male children in Bethlehem. And in all that region, who were 2 years old or under, according to the time I had ascertained from the wise men.
Then Herod, when he saw that he had been tricked by the wise men, became furious, and he sent and killed all the male children in Bethlehem and in all that region who were 2 years old or under, according to the time that he asserted from the wise men. Then was fulfilled what was spoken by the prophet Jeremiah. Thus says the Lord, a voice is heard in Ramah, lamentation and bitter weeping. Rachel is weeping for her children. She refuses to be comforted for her children because they are no more.
Have this mind among yourselves, which is yours in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not count equality with God a thing to be grasped, but emptied himself by taking the form of a servant, being born in the likeness of men, and being found in human form, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. And every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father.
Thank you. So this is a video we made according to your recorder last Saturday. And thank God, give us opportunity. We can participate. And thank for all the brothers and sisters, your attend for next year's Christmas, before Christmas, actually Christmas Eve. Hopefully we can perform together on the stage, or we can perform from the Metaverse, the virtual environment at will. 那刚才这个短片呢，是我们根据您在上个星期六啊所做的音频来去录制的。那非常感谢上帝能够给我们这样一个机会，让我们教会的弟兄姐妹一起参与进来去做这样一个视频。明年的圣诞节，圣诞前夜的话呢，我们希望我们会真正在舞台上每个人去表演啊。如果不可能的话，那我们通过这个线上的 3D 的 Metaverse 这种空间，也希望大家一起参与。内容也是差不多一个内容，因为我们都是根据圣经的原文来去做的，只不过是表演的人和形式会有变化啊。那我在这里的话再总结一下我们这个视频里面所讲的一个内容。So I'm going to give you a brief summary about what this video talk about the Christmas. The Christmas is all about the King Jesus born to this world. The flesh and the world became flesh. And he came this world, the reason he came this world before he came, that's perfect. They told everybody said, there's going to be a king and the Messiah going to come to this world. And then it really happened as the prophet said. At that moment, they have a shepherd, the wise man, everybody witnessed Jesus born. And right after that, the history fact repeated itself, reproved Jesus born as a prophet. This is a true story you should remember in your heart. Jesus was born for us. It happened, and that's why we have hope. Later on, we're going to learn why and how and what happened after he born this world. 那关于圣诞节呢，我想给大家再总结一下这个耶稣诞生啊，在首先有先知在很多年很多年以前呢，就预言了会有这么一个救世主诞生。这不是人随便编出来的啊，在很多年以前都有先知预言了。那然后呢，事情就按照先知的预言真正的就发生了。那发生的时候呢，当场啊有这个牧羊人呢，还有这个远方来的智者。你看他这里面有两个不同的人啊，一个是在这附近的牧羊人啊，听说了就跑过来的，还有一个是远道而来的智者。多少月之前，那时候没有公交，没有公交车，也没有飞机，也没有火车，他们要骑着骆驼走多远才能到这里啊，跟着这个星星，最后在耶稣诞生那一天晚上，在马棚里啊，他们看到了。所以说有附近就近跑过来的牧羊人，还有远道而来的这个智者，再加上耶稣诞生之后这个希律王对他的一个追杀，还有发生了很多事情，就从一开始的预言到现场的证明，一直到后来历史发生的证明，都说明了我们的主耶稣基督是真实的道成肉身来到这个世界。那他来到这个世界是为了什么呢？那做了哪些事情呢？我们在明年学圣经的时候啊，会接着来学习。那今天呢，我们准备去来具体讲一讲这个耶稣他来到这里对我们来讲他是一个什么意义啊。 So today we are going to focus what's the purpose Jesus born to this world. What is the meaning of his borning, right?那首先我们来看一下这节经文啊。So first let's read Hebrews chapter 8 verse 1 and verse 7 through 8. Now, the point in what we are seeing is we have such a high priest, one who is seated at the right hand of the throne of the majesty in heaven. For if that first covenant had been faultless,there would have been no occasion to look for a second. For he finds fault with them when he says, Behold, the days are coming, declares the Lord, when I will establish a new covenant with the house of Israel and with the house of Judah. The point is, a high priest seated at the right hand of the throne in heaven. And he told us, the days are coming, declares the Lord, and he established a new covenant with everybody who trusts in him. 希伯来书第八章第一节和七第七节和第八节所说的，就是我们所讲的事情，第一要紧的就是我们有这样一个大祭司，他坐在天上至大者宝座的右边。第一个约若没有瑕疵，就无去寻找第二个约了。所以上帝指责他们说，主啊，看哪，日子将到，我将与以色列家和犹大家另立新约。那保罗在希伯来书这一段经文就告诉我们说，有这样一个大祭司，他是坐在上帝的右边。那摩西颁布了律法，但是以色列人没有能够遵从，所以说呢，就派了耶稣来了，给我们立了一个新约，带来了真理和恩典。所以说这样一个新约呢，使我们能够有机会得救，因为以色列人没有办法守旧约，也没有人能够守住旧约哈。那么对于我们来讲，怎么样才能够去遵守新约呢？既然以色列人这些虔诚的犹太人他们都不能够遵守他们旧约，我们又怎么可能去遵守了新约呢？ So how could we obey the new covenant if the Israel failed already, even though they trusted the Lord so much and they couldn't abide themselves with the law from Moses? 那接下来我们今天呢是一个特别的日子啊，12月31号了，那么中国已经是晚上时间，那个美国已经是白天时间了。我相信你们今天晚上会看到这么一幕啊，就是 countdown 啊，这倒数啊，12月31号12点的时候啊，会倒数迎接新年，迎接2023年，然后是庆祝2023年啊。那庆祝2023年呢之后呢，你会有一个计划。So everybody, I think most of people are going to countdown.From 2022 to 2023 tonight from midnight. And after the midnight, and you're going to come to the new world. And normally, you're going to write a new year resolution 2023. 啊，通常你会写一个关于2023年的一个决议啊，你2023年的一个计划，你准备做哪些事情。那非常有意思的事情呢，在美国呢，很多人呢在年底的时候呢会规划第二年的一个决议，自己的一个计划，然后呢写了很长的一个 list， 但是往往呢都没有完全执行，所以很多人最后都放弃了，不再写这样一个清单了。但作为一个传统来讲，很多人还在想我明年要做哪些事情。 So normally in America, a lot of people write down this resolution, that long list every year and every year, but unfortunately only a few people canGo through that, and a lot of people failed. So some people just don't read at all because they know they're going to fail, right? 那我们今天来看一下，对于我们来讲2023年我们要做什么事情。 So to us, what we are going to do in 2023. So that come to today's Bible study. The subject is the counting down.啊，就是这个倒数了哈。那么我在这个图片上，你看中间有个词叫mediator， 左边叫 conflicts， 右边叫 conflicts。 就在这个世界上啊，总是有很多的争端，然后呢你可以看到这个每个国家的政权不同，还有法律不同，然后呢每一个家庭还每一族人他有不同的一些自己的要求，所以经常会有一些矛盾啊，家庭之间，这个家与家之间有矛盾啊，父母之间有矛盾，父母父子之间也有矛盾，在学校之间也有矛盾，这个矛盾到处都是。那在这样一个矛盾中怎么能够解决呢？在社会中呢，我们通常会有法院来解决哈。So between all the conflicts, how are we going to solve the issues? Normally is from the court, but from us, we have a mediator.So we failed from Eden, we sinned, all sinned. How we are able to come back to God, to build a relationship with God again, that's why we need a mediator. 那因为我们通过亚当一个人犯罪，每个人都犯了罪呢，那我们怎么样能与上帝和好呢？啊，那么我们要像这个世界的法院一样，我们需要有一个中间人，一个中保，也就是叫英语叫 mediator。那接下来呢，我们请伊森来领读，请伊布来跟读一下希伯来书第一章一到三节。So now I'm going to ask Ethan to read, and some brother or sister follow him to read Hebrews chapter 1, verse 1 to 3.
107, look, 谢谢。
Long ago,
at many times,
and in many ways, God spoke to our fathers,
by the prophets.
But in these
last days,
He has spoken to us,
by His Son,
whom He appointed.
The heir
of all things, through whom also he created, the world. He is
the radiance.
Of the glory of God, and the exact imprint
of his nature,
and he upholds
the universe,
by the word. Of his power,
after making purification
for sins,
he sat down
at the right hand
of the majesty on high.
All right, thank you. So from Hebrews chapter 1, verse 1 through 3, long ago, God spoke to our fathers, everybody, by the prophet. But in these last days, He spoke to us by His Son, Jesus Christ. He appointed to the everything through Jesus, and Jesus, He is the radiance of the glory of God and making purification for sins. Jesus sat down at the right hand of majesty on high. 那我们来再请这个 Luke 来读中文部分，请医生来跟 Luke 来读一遍中文部分哈。医生 you're going to follow Luke to read the Chinese part, and Luke going to lead you to read this Chinese from Hebrews chapter 1, verse 1 to 3.
古时候，
上帝，
急着，
众先知，多次，
多方，
向，
列祖。
说话，
末世，
急着，他儿子，向，我们，说话，又立，他为，承受，万有，
的，
也急着，他创造，
趁着，
宇宙， Unjo.
Tashi.
Tashi.
Shandi.
Shandi.
Zhongyan.
Zhongyan.
The Guanghui.
Pogoni. Pohong. Sorry, can you say that again?
Yes. Guanghui.
Pogi. Pogi.
Shi Shandi.
Shi Shandi.
Bunti.
Bunti.
The.
Ba.
Zhen Xiang.
Zhen Xiang.
Chang Yong.
Chang Yong.
Ta.
Ta.
Ba Men.
Ba Men.
The.
The.
Ning Ning.
Ning Ning.
Tuo Zhu.
Tuo Zhu.
Wang Yong.
Wang Yong.
Ta.
Ta.
Xi Jiu.
Xi Jiu.
La Ren.
La Ren.
The Zui.
The Zui.
Jiu Zuo.
Tuo Zhu. Tuo Zhu.
就坐在高天至大者是半日的右边。
All right, thank you, Luke. Thank you, Ethan. 那希伯来书第一章一到三节就说，在过去的时候啊，上帝给这些以色列人他的先祖说话是通过先知来说的，那在末世的时候呢，上帝是通过耶稣基督来说的，那耶稣基督是承受万有的上帝，通过也是借着他呢创造了宇宙万物，他是上帝荣耀的光辉，是上帝本体的真相，他用他的大能托住万有，耶稣基督洗净了人的罪，坐在高天至大者的右边啊，所以今天呢，我们准备通过两部分来讲一下耶稣基督。So today we're going to review Jesus from two points. Number one is the mediator. Number two is the preaching. The preaching we have three points. One is for non-believer. Number two is for believer. Number three is for failed and raised again believer. 那今天呢，我们讲耶稣呢，准备从两部分来讲一下，一个呢就是关于他的中保的身份，一个呢关于他的教导。关于耶稣的教导呢，我们选了三部分，一个对于非信徒，就是不信耶稣基督的人，他是怎么教导的；一个呢是对于信徒，相信耶稣基督的人，他是怎么教导他们的；第三个呢，针对那些信徒，但是呢又失败了的人重新回到耶稣基督这边，他又是怎么教导的。好，我们通过这两部分，然后第二部又分了三部分。 Now, this Bible study I'm going to go over quickly because we review a lot of stuff at the beginning. 我就跟大家今天就过得快一点啊，因为我们一开始就 review 了很多不同的东西。 So first let's see the mediator. 第一个首先看一下谁，什么叫 mediator 中保啊。在这张图片呢，你可以看到哈，这个右边呢叫 Dimitro 啊，是乌克兰的一个外交官啊。他前两天呢，要求是这样要求的 ：Ukraine wants to hold a peace summit at the United Nations by the end of February. They want United Nations Secretary General to serve as the mediator at a potential peace summit because the United Nations could be the best venue.For holding this summit, because this is not about making a favor to a certain country. So while Ukraine want the United Nations to become the mediator because United Nations is not about making a favor to a certain country. So the mediator is not going to make a favor to each side, but...to be a fair enough bring two people together who have conflicts. 那乌克兰的这个外交官呢，当时他说希望这个联合国作为他的中保来去 在2023年的时候呢，带给他和俄国呢有一个和平的协议。他这个提议提了10点呢，他为什么要求联合国作为他的一个中保呢？因为联合国啊，他是不偏向于任何一个国家，他相信联合国的一个公力啊。所以说作为一个中保来讲，他一定是一个中立的，他不偏向于任何一个人的。说上帝派耶稣基督作为中保，他也不是偏向于哪一边，他是帮助我们能够恢复与上帝和好。因为我们先祖亚当夏娃犯了罪，结果我们犯了罪之后一定要死，那上帝还想救我们复活，那在这种不可调和的矛盾之中怎么办呢？所以说呢，上帝就派耶稣基督他作为中保来替我们而死，解决了这一个终端，使我们能够有机会获得永生啊。So that's the purpose of the mediator, because the mediator from God, Jesus become the mediator, so he can be between man and God to solve the issues between God and man, because we are all sent. 1 Timothy chapter 2 verse 5, for there is one God, and there is one mediator between God and man, the man Christ Jesus. 因为只有一位上帝，在上帝和人之间也只有一个中保，是成为人的耶稣基督耶稣。Hebrews chapter 9 verse 15, therefore he is the mediator of a new covenant, so that those who are called may receive the promised eternal inheritance, since a death has occurred that redeems them from the transgressions committed as the first covenant. 为此耶稣基督呢也做了新约的中保，因为他的死除了人在第一个约之时所犯的罪过，使蒙召的人都能得到所应许永远的产业啊。在这一点我想特别做一个解释哈。So I'm going to give you a little special brief introduction. Moses introduced the law, but everybody failed. And God sent Jesus as new covenant so people can inherit God's promised land, because God's promise never changed.Of human beings had changed. 那对于上帝呢是爱世人的，但是因为那个以色列人没有能够遵守摩西的约，所以上帝呢就派了耶稣作为中保跟我们立了新约，是我们在耶稣基督里呢能够继承他给我们所做的一个产业。 Numbers chapter 16 verse 48, and he stood between the dead and the living, and the plague was stopped.那他站在活人和死人之间，瘟疫就停止了哈，就是他来耶稣基督要调整了上帝与人之间的这种不和啊。Hebrews chapter 7 verse 22 to 25, this makes it Jesus the guarantor of a better covenant. The former priests were many in number,because they are prevented by death from continuing in office. But he holds his priesthood permanently, because he continues forever. Consequently, he is able to save to the uttermost those who draw near to God through him, since he always lives to make intercession for them. 希伯来书第七章22-25节说，既是启示立的耶稣做了更美之约的中保，一方面那些成为祭司的数目本来多，是因为受死亡限制不能长久留住，另一方面这位祭司永久留住的，他具有不可更换的祭司职位，所以凡靠着他进入上帝面前的，他都能拯救到底，因为他长远活着为他祈求啊。所以在这一点我想跟大家说的，耶稣基督作为我们的大祭司，他不像人的祭司一样，他会有死亡然后会有更换，好像是这一代死了之后又有一个新的祭司不一定再替你求了，耶稣基督他是永远的，他永远都在上帝面前替我们祈求，我们能够在他里面行在上帝的意愿里面呢，他就一定能够拯救我们到底啊，虽然我们会失败。那本来今天我想给大家再听一首这个歌曲 All Worship the King 啊，因为时间关系我们就不再听了，有机会你们可以去找来听一下啊。然后第二点的话呢，我们今天讲的是 The Preaching 啊，就是耶稣基督的教导，它总共有三点很重要啊，一个对于非信徒，一个对于信徒，一个对于信徒但是又失败重新回到上帝面前的。首先我们看一下对于非信徒 他是怎么教导的哈。我们请医生来读一下，请预备跟读一下 Matthew chapter 4 verse 17. So let's listen to read and somebody follow him to read Matthew chapter 4 verse 17.
203, Teresa, 谢谢。
From that time,
Jesus began to preach, saying, Repent,
for the kingdom
of heaven is at hand. Repent, or perish.
All right, thank you. From Matthew chapter 4, verse 17, Jesus began to preach. He told everybody, said, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. 耶稣开始宣讲的就是说，你们要悔改，因为天国近了。所以就你作为一个非信徒或者不一定现在相信上帝的人，你就有两个选择。You have two options. Either repent, either perish. 啊，要不你就悔改，要不就灭亡。为什么这样说呢？我们来看一下路加福音第13章1-5节。So why is that either you repent or perish? Let's look at Luke chapter 13 verse 1-5. There were some present at that every very time who told him about the Galileans whose blood Pilate had mingled with their sacrifice. And he answered them, do you think that these Galileans were worse sinners than all the other Galileans? Because they suffered in this way? No, I tell you. But unless you repent, you will all likewise perish. All those 18 on whose the tower of Solomon fell and killed them. Do you think that they were worse offenders than all the others who live in Jerusalem? No, I tell you. But unless you repent, you will all likewise perish. So Jesus told everybody, it doesn't matter. Look at other people, what they did wrong. Unless you repent, you will all likewise perish. 那路加福音第13章1-5节就这样说的哈，这个耶稣对这些人说，你以为这些加利利人比他人更有罪吗？啊，你以为这个西罗亚楼倒塌压死了18人，这些人比这个耶路撒冷的人更有罪吗？不是这样的，所以你不要看别人好像是啊，人家没有学圣经啊，然后你学了圣经啊，人家没有祷告，你有祷告啊，好像是人家没有一个好行为，你有个好行为，好像是你比他更好，他们比你更有罪，不是这样的啊。耶稣这样说的：若不悔改，都同样要灭亡啊！就无论你怎么，如果你不悔改，都同样要灭亡。所以说，耶稣基督对这些非信徒说啊。你一定要悔改，来到我的面前。你不悔改，就一定要灭亡。So let's look at what Jesus told the believers. 那我们来看一下耶稣对这些信徒怎么说的哈。Matthew chapter 28, verse 18 through 20. And Jesus came and said to them, All authorities in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore,and make disciples of all nations, baptize them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I'm with you always, to the end of the age. So Matthew chapter 28, verse 18 through 20, Jesus told his disciples what they should do. If you are believers, you should go, and make disciples, baptize them, teach them to obey his word. 那马太福音第28章18-20节，耶稣对他的门徒，也就是说对于信徒来说什么呢？你们要去使万民做我的门徒，就是你要传福音， 要奉圣父、圣子、圣灵的名给他们施洗，凡他所吩咐的都要教导这些人遵守啊！不仅仅是让他做他门徒，还要给他们施洗；不仅仅让他们施洗，还要教导他们遵守耶稣基督的话语啊！So the cost of discipleship 啊，做门徒的代价你要小心了、啊、你不要说哎呀，我愿意去做啊，做门徒代价是什么呢？ Luke chapter 14 verse 26 through 27 and 33 If anyone comes to me and does not hate his own father and mother and wife and children and brothers and sisters, yes, and even his own life, he cannot be my disciple. Whoever does not bear his own crossAnd come after me cannot be my disciple. So, therefore, any one of you who does not renounce all that he has cannot be my disciple. To Luke chapter 14, verse 26 through 27, 33, Jesus told us, if we want to be his disciple, we have to hate our own father, mother, children, wife, brothers, by our own cross. Otherwise, we cannot be his disciple.So what means we have to hate? That means we cannot love any of them more than him. That's the point. 那路加福音第14章26到27节还是33节说怎么来做耶稣基督的门徒啊？你要做耶稣基督的门徒必须要爱他胜过爱自己的父母、妻子、儿女、姐妹甚至自己的性命背起自己的十字架啊！中文把它翻译的 hate 变成了我刚才讲的意思了哈，不是说是恨你的父母，而是说要爱耶稣胜过爱自己的性命、父母、妻子、儿女、兄弟、姊妹，然后还要背着自己的十字架，这样的话才能做耶稣基督的门徒。所以做耶稣基督的门徒不是那么简单的哈。So then let's look at the failed and raised again believer. 那有些人说我是信徒，但是我失败了。然后呢我又回来了，耶稣怎么说的呢？ Luke chapter 22 verse 31 through 34 Simon, Simon, behold, Satan demanded to have you, that he might sift you like wheat. But I have prayed for you that your faith may not fail. And when you have turned again, strengthen your brothers. Peter said to him, Lord, I'm ready to go with you.Both to praise and to death. Jesus said, I tell you, Peter, the rooster will not crow this day until you deny three times that you know me. So from this chapter, Peter told Jesus he will ready to die and go to prison with him. But Jesus said, no, you're going to deny me. And Satan demand to have you. But don't worry. When you have turned again,Strengthen your brothers, because I have prayed for you that your faith may not fail. So if you are the believers, don't worry about that. If you failed, it's okay, because Jesus prayed for you, and he's going to strengthen you. And upon you came back to be the witness, to testify, and tell other people that will. 路加福音第22章31到34节彼得说哎呀我要跟你耶稣基督一起坐牢与你同死啊！耶稣说你不要这样说了我告诉你啊那个撒旦要得着你鸡没叫你要三次就说不认识我了那这时候怎么办就像我们做基督徒来讲你可能会失败不要怕为啥呢就像耶稣说的撒旦虽然要得着你但是耶稣基督在为我们祈求使我们不至于失了信心如果我们失败了我们赶快就悔改一旦我悔改了之后我们就应该把我们的失败告诉其他弟兄姐妹就像在自己经文所说的你回头以后要兼顾你的弟兄啊，要 testify 好了 don't declare Lord's name easily 啊，不要妄称主的名有人说哎呀，我相信上帝我悔改了不要妄称主的名啊，在这个马太福音第七章21到23节这样说的哈Matthew chapter 7 verse 24 to 23 Not everyone who says to me Lord, Lord will enter the kingdom of heaven but the one who does the will of my Father who is in heaven On that day many will say to me Lord, Lord, did we not prophesy in your name and cast out demons in your name and do many mighty works in your name And then will I declare to them I never knew youDepart from me, you workers of lawlessness. 马太福音第七章二十一到二十三节说，不是每一个人称我主啊主啊的人都能进天国，不要以为好像是人家说我是以上帝名义做的这些人就可以进天国的。耶稣这样说的，我从来都不认识你们，你们这些作恶的人，给我走开。为啥呢？所以你不可妄称耶稣基督的名啊，说不要妄称耶稣基督的名。那今天有一个conclusion啊，最后一个结论，就是说约翰福音第一章十七到十八节， For the law was given through Moses, grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God, the only God, who is at the Father's side, he has made him known. So from John chapter 1 verse 17 through 18, this told us, the law was given through Moses, grace and truth came from Jesus Christ. No one ever seen God, but we see God through Jesus Christ. 约翰福音第一章十七到十八节就这样说，律法是由摩西颁布的，摩西颁布了律法，以色列失败了。那现在新约来了，耶稣基督就带给我们了恩典和真理。什么叫恩典？就你本不应该得的，上帝给了你了。那没有人见过上帝，你怎么知道上帝呢？就是在耶稣基督里我们看到了上帝对我们的爱。 Psalms chapter 32 verse 1 verse 6 verse 8 through 11, Blessed is the one whose transgression is forgiven, whose sin is covered. Therefore, let everyone who is godly offer prayer to you at a time when you may be found. Surely, in the wrath of great waters, they shall not reach him. Remember,Blessed is the one whose transgression is forgiven at a time when you may be found. 那在这里要注意啊，过犯得赦免，罪恶蒙遮羞的人有福了。但是呢，要记住，趁你可寻找的时候要祷告啊，这样的话大水泛滥的时候必淋不到他。I will instruct you and teach you in the way you shall go. I will counsel you with my eye upon you.Be not like a horse or mule without understanding, which must be curbed with bit and bridle, or it will not stay near you. So let us not like a horse or mule. Because why? Because we don't understand God's word. God has used his a lot of stuff to force us to listen to him. Don't let us do that. We have to listen to God. God is going to counsel us with his own eyes.God is going to instruct us and teach us in the way we should go. 在这里经文说，我们不要像那些无知的罗马啊，需要用缰绳啊勒住才行啊。就像我们说，我们不愿听从上帝的话语，上帝要兴起环境压迫我们，我们才不得不听从上帝的话语，不知悔改。我们要像什么呢？我们要遵从主耶稣基督的教导。因为耶稣他说了，他要教导我们，指示我们当行的路，他要定睛在我们身上劝诫我们。 Many are the sorrows of the wicked, but the steadfast love surrounds the one who trusts in the Lord. Be glad in the Lord and rejoice, O righteous, and shout for joy, all you upright in heart. So sorrows of the wickedLove, surround, trust in the Lord. Let's be glad and rejoice in our heart. 恶人呢，都必多受苦楚，唯有依靠耶和华的，必有慈爱赦免环绕他。所以说，义人呢，我们都应该依靠耶和华，欢喜快乐。其你正直的人呢，都应该欢呼。在诗篇的这些经文就告诉我们，当你生活发生困顿的时候，一定要相信上帝，然后上帝会带领你。当你生活多受苦楚的时候，一定要悔改，让自己从错误中走出来。 So when you feel like sorrow, when you feel like difficult, you have trust in the Lord, and you have to be glad and rejoice, follow the God's instructions. That is today's conclusions. So originally we want to listen to the song Joy into the World, but we don't have time, we're going to drop that. 我们本来今天要听这个这个欢喜这个世界啊，但是没有时间了，我们就不听了。那最后一个应用啊，很快， Hebrews chapter 10 verse 19 through 25. Therefore, brothers, since we have confidence to enter the holy place by the blood of Jesus, but the new and living way that he opened for us through the curtain, that is through his flesh. And since we have a great priest over the house of Lord, a God, let us draw near with a true heart in full assurance of faith, with our heart sprinkled clean from an evil conscience and our body washed with pure water. 希伯来书的第十九第十章十九到二十五节啊，首先说，所以弟兄们，就像弟兄姐妹们，今天我们所听到的所有的人呢，既然我们是靠着耶稣基督的血得以坦然进入圣所，那我们有这么一个伟大的祭司治理上帝的家，我们就应该诚心用诚心和充足的信心，同以蒙洁净无愧的良心和水来洗净我们的身体，来亲近上帝啊。Let us hold fast the confession of our hope without wavering, for he who promised is faithful. And let us consider how to stir up one another to love and good works, not nagging to meet each other as is the habit of some, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the day draw near. So let us meet together.Not nagging to meet. 就像在这一节经文说，我们要坚守所宣认的指望，彼此相顾，不可停止聚会啊。所以我们要不可停止聚会，特别在2023年的时候，让我们能够回到上帝的面前来，一心的依靠他，让我们能够通过聚会相互的团契来敬拜上帝。Especially in the coming 2023, let us not stop to meet each other. We worship God together, and so we can all.Going to heaven together.So that's today's study. I'm sorry for the late, a little bit of time. And let Ethan give our prayer. 非常对不起啊，今天的时间有点长。那我们请 Ethan 来给我们做一个结束祷告。Ethan, can you pray for us for today's study?
Okay. God, thank you. Thank you for your son cleansing our sins and thanking you for having mercy on us. Even though we have sinned many, many times,Thank you for always forgiving us and always loving us, no matter what. And thank you for letting us meet up here to get here. And I hope you can support us in the future and always guide us into the right path. I praise Jesus. Amen.
Amen. 好，感谢大家啊！我愿大家有一个新的开始，2023年能有一个新的一年，愿上帝与你同在。So may God have a real new blessing day in 2023. May God be with you and God bless you all.
Bye.
好，希望下周我们再见。So see you next week.
God bless you. Bye. Bye.